And Mitch.
How you doing, folks? I'm Brian. You are Chords and Notes Nation because you are here on this channel watching these videos. We are on to track 5, Never Let Go, off of Camel's debut album, Camel. Check out the first 4 reactions I've done. You'll get an idea of where I'm coming from, but so far so good. I enjoy this. Description box below has information if you want to contribute to the album. If you want to see me outside of this channel, there are places to do so. If you have song requests, Patreon is, and other ways. And please go ahead and check out Patreon. Chords and Notes Nation is the name of my channel there. There are things beyond music reactions that I will post. Am posting there as well. Rumble channel. Don't forget about that. Anyways, all that information will be below. Let's continue our journey. Never let go. Never let go of this journey. Just don't. Just don't do it. You don't want to. It's not good. Oh my goodness. That sounded so familiar. Oh my God. Benighted, Opeth. Those first few notes. Structure is very the same, very much the same too. Opeth, I know, is big into prog. I bet you that he got some inspiration from this. Go check it out if you haven't. Benighted by Opeth. You'll see the similarity, you'll hear it.
Quite the bass player.
telling you. Go check that song out, Unedited, Opeth. The intro is so, so similar. The length of it, too. So much to say on this. First of all, this band can jam. They can jam. They can bring it. Even though they're, it just seemed like the first couple of songs on this album was very, let me not get ahead of myself. All of the compositions are solid compositions. They're not overdoing anything. They're not going into this, let's throw in a million different time signature changes or tempo shifts and all that sort of stuff. There are plenty of them, but they're done in a very tasteful way. Their playing ability is really, really good. They seem to be more jazzy. I guess that's the word I want to use. More jazzy. It just seems like there's more of that feel in their playing. And I just get the feeling, that this, they're more seasoned musicians than you would, than you would expect for a debut album. And maybe they, I don't know when they got started doing this, but maybe they got started a little bit later than their peers. Some of these bands, you know, they get started really young in their teens. But these guys just have this, this ability to put together music that just seems very smooth, well-crafted, not obnoxious in the prog sense, and very jazzy. Now, these lyrics caught me. Crazy preachers of our doom. First of all, preachers don't necessarily mean just religious, okay? Even though that word is associated with it. Telling us there is no room, not enough for all mankind, and the seas of time are running dry. Don't they know it's a lie? You know, we have these secular preachers out there now that are really pushing for saying that we're destroying everything and we're the reason for all of these environmental problems that are actually... I'm not even going to get deep into it. I've got so much to say, and that'll probably happen with a different type of video that I put out. However, what I want to say is, so in this first stanza, they're talking about, and that's really when they started pushing this stuff about, global warming and all of this that they're screaming about right now, that they're demonizing the human race, and they want to reduce the size of humanity, and because there's too many of us and we can't survive, and you know, everything's drying up and blah 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 blah. So yeah, that's really relevant to today. Then there's another stanza about, I hear them talk about Kingdom Come, I hear them discuss Armageddon. So now he's kind of going into the end times prophecies in the book of Revelation, and also throughout the Gospels, throughout the Bible, really. And so this is how I'm taking it. So you've got the one stanza that is more or less the secular approach to everything's gonna, and then you have the other stanza where it's taking the biblical prophecies that everything's gonna, although that's not, I'm way oversimplifying it. That's not how it's not written that way. And then in between, he's making the argument, well, but mankind has this innate will that's about survival, and we won't accept this. So it's a very, you know, it's I get what he's saying, and it's about time. I hear something like this from them lyrically. And I can get into the depths of what I really want to say elsewhere, but I'm trying to keep this focused on the music, somewhat on the lyrics, but I can extrapolate so much from what they were saying and just go off on this 2-hour long tangent. So this isn't the video for that. Musically, they're starting to do more within their compositions, but it's not obnoxious at this point. And it's, what do I mean by obnoxious? And I don't mean, maybe I shouldn't use that word, but I don't mean it in a negative light. I think of Gettr Hotel, where they have so many musicians that are so good, and they just, there's just so much going on, especially in the 70s with their compositions. This seems more of a scaled down version of Tull. I'm going to leave it at that. Sorry. I'm just trying to figure out a better way of putting it. And it's not knocking Tull, because I listened to a whole shit ton of Tull when I was growing up, and I really liked them. But anyways, that's neither here nor there right now. Anyways, be well, stay well. God bless you. Read Joshua 1:9. Get it in your heart. Get it in your mind. And I will talk to you in the next video.